So what if you're exclusive and then suddenly he needs a break? This is happening to me. It's been a few days since I've heard from him. Yeah, I mean, a few days isn't really the biggest thing in the world, right? Like, I'll get these women that are like, oh yeah, this guy ghosted on me for like 4 days. And it's like, okay, you know, is that really ghosting? You know, normal kind of relationships, most people don't need to be kind of connected to each other like every minute of every day, right? And some people that, like, actually, I was just talking to this men's dating coach not too long ago, and we were talking about kind of like texting and calling practices that men have and what he's teaching. And one of the things that he was talking about was he actually, especially for the initial parts of a relationship, he doesn't have men, he tells men not to text more than like once a week. So he tells his guys, don't reach out to a woman more than once a week and initiate a conversation, which, you know, I don't particularly agree with. However, it goes to show you that there's a lot of stuff out there where people are like, oh, okay, well, this is a normal conversation. And if she wants to talk more, she'll contact you for, if she wants to have more of a conversation with you than, you know, something that's once a week. And so it's one of those things, like, I wouldn't worry so much if it's only been a few days since a guy started talking to you, then, you know, just give him some time, right? Like, give him, just let him kind of back off, let him kind of go and do his thing. You know, if you really feel like you need to contact him and reach out to him, you can it's not like leaning back. We were just talking actually in our community about leaning back, and leaning back doesn't mean that you can't like reach out and connect with a guy. You can't like contact him. What it does mean is that he needs to be putting an effort and energy when you are connecting with him, if he wants to connect with you. And so if a guy hasn't, I mean, if it's just been a couple of days, I wouldn't even worry about it. You know, that's another one of the things that I was talking about with the whole scarcity thing, right? Have other things that are going on in your life. So you're not just so focused on this guy, like, oh my God, it's been 2-3 days since he's contacted me. Oh my God, I'm freaking out right now. It's like, you should have other things going on in your life. You should be meeting other people. You should be going out and doing and having other interests, so that it's not like you're so stuck on whether this guy has contacted you in the last couple of days or not. So that you can, you know, it's not a problem. You're not freaking out. And so, you know, I get it. I get it when you freak out. And, you know, it's been like that, but you need to like have a bigger life than just him. That way it kind of sucks all of that out. And it's like, oh yeah, he hasn't contacted me in a couple of days. Wow, that's weird. I wonder if everything's okay, instead of like, oh my God, he hasn't contacted me in a couple of days and I'm freaking out right now and I need to fight, you know, like, does he not love me? You know, like all those things that start going through your head. If you've got an amazing life and all these kinds of things that are going on for you, then you're not going to be freaking out if a guy takes a couple of days and has to go and sit in his man cave or his cocoon or whatever it is that you want to call it.